Hello YouTube, this is Metro here, and I'm going to do a somewhat quick video of the Beats Wireless by Dr. Dre. Now, I chose to buy these because I'm in college, and walking around college campus, sometimes it's easier to not have a cord coming out of your pocket, and sometimes you still like having the cord. So I have these, and they're alright. And the first thing I want to address is what many of you might be wondering is, can you still use a cord? And when I first researched these things, it didn't look like you could. The first models that came out, you could not. They just came wirelessly, and that's all that they did. I researched a little bit more. I went to a few different stores, and I was in a Best Buy in New York, which I live in, not New York, but I was in there, and they had them, and they came with a cord. On the back of the box, it says, I don't have the box with me right now, but on the back of the box, it has a little audio cable thing, and then this particular model right here has that little headphone jack right underneath the right earmuff. And this is the right earmuff because it has the controls on it. You can see the little buttons in there. And the big button's actually a button too. I'll get to that later. But yes, they can have a cord. This is the cord that comes with them. It has audio control on it right here. It doesn't have the volume up and down. It has play, pause, skip, skip back. This little red button that looks to be like the cord, but it's not. It's just a little button. And this end is the one that plugs into your Beats. And this end is what plugs into everything else. So I'll show you how it works. First, you go to settings. My Bluetooth is already on, but on my iPad, you go to settings, and then you go to general, and scroll. Where is it? Oh, no, Bluetooth is right here. Okay, Bluetooth is on. And it says Beats Wireless. It's not connected. My Beats Wireless are currently off. So once you connect them to a particular device, say you want to use them with your iPad at all times, or you want to use them with your phone at all times, as long as it's connected to that, you can turn these off, and then they're off, and you can just go turn Bluetooth off. But I keep it on just so I can power them up quickly, which I'll show you what that means. Is it drains a little bit of my battery, but it's worth it in the end because my iPad lasts all day. So on the Beats Wireless control, this button appears the power button. I'm going to hold that one in. And that little light flashes on, and that now means that I'm connected, or the battery's dying. Yeah, the battery's getting low, but I'm connected. And so I'm connected right now. It says connected right on the screen right here. You can't really see it, but it says connected. So, oh, jeez, wow, sorry about that. Wow, I scared myself, I hope I didn't scare you. I gotta get my tripod working again. Wow. Okay, I'll be right back. Sorry, the tripod's broken. Wow, okay, that was a dilemma, but I'm back. Sorry about that. As I said, I just turned the power on and connected the Beats Wireless. They automatically connect once I turn it on, so you don't have to go into the settings every time and do that. That might be another common question. I'll go to my music on my iPad, and I will go to my playlists. Oh, that was albums. Those are my purchase playlists. I'll go down. These are my, I like going to my new songs. Let me see. Yep. So now my Beats Wireless are currently working. You can hear them. So on here, there's a little flashing thing. Right here's a skip button, skip backwards. So if I want to restart the song, tap it, it's restarting the song. This big button, play pause. The big Beats button is the play pause. There's a little bit of lag to it, but it's not bad. And then volume down and volume up has two little bumps. So they get pretty loud. They're not necessarily stereo headphones, but look, there's no wire. That's the thing. I put these on my head and walk around, people kind of stare at me like, what the heck is he doing? But no, there's no wire. It's kind of cool. So now you hear what they're like without a wire. I'll let it play a little bit so you can hear it. Alright, paused it. Now, I will show you what it sounds like with the cord plugged in. So just take the cord, and in the right earmuff, just plug it in. And I think the Bluetooth turns off when you do that. I'm not positive. I think so. And then I'll go to my iPad. Plug it in. And now I play it. Now I'll get louder. When it's wired, they get louder. The frequency can be transmitted easier. It's very clear why that is. Because I'm transferring a Bluetooth signal, it ruptures it a little bit. I mean, it messes with the audio just a little bit. But actually, bass sometimes is better without the cord. I don't quite know why. That's just what it seems to be. And these sound really nice with the cord too. They're fantastic headphones. They're still, I believe, to be better than Solos because these earmuffs are a little bit bigger. They completely cover your ear. They're not just like the little tiny cups. They completely cover over your ear. This part does not go over your ear at all. It rests on your ears, which isn't as nice as the other Beats. The wireless feature is very nice. It can connect to your PlayStation, which was one of the main reasons I bought it. However, I will tell you what other people didn't tell me is that you can voice chat, but you cannot actually hear what's going on the PlayStation. So it's a Bluetooth headset, that's what it is. So it can work with chat and stuff, but you cannot actually get like the nice beat sound on your PlayStation while you're playing Call of Duty or when you're playing a game where you have surround sound. It doesn't work like that. That's why I bought these. They were $270 when I bought them. I think they were like $10 off. They're normally $280. But yeah, it's like my official opinion. Well, I like this part. Yeah, love these headphones. They're sweet. If I were to do it over again, if I were paying that much money for headphones, I wouldn't go for these. I'm just helping you guys out. Here, let's see how it's turned on. There we go. This connects automatically when I turn on, as you guys saw. Still get pretty loud. I think the bass on your ears really sounds better. And these are very cushy. They're very, very nice. Very good quality. Mine still look really nice. I've had them five months now. I got them pretty much when they came out. And I was so excited to see the wireless. But, like I said, if I were to do it again, I wouldn't get them. And that's very hard to say because I like them so much. But that much money on headphones, if I were to go back, I'd buy the Bose QC15 just because they're the best headphones, period. In college, it would be nice to have the noise canceling because there's a lot of outside noise you might not want. So Bose QC15 are the best headphones, and if I wouldn't get those, if I wouldn't mind spending it any more money, I would probably buy Beats Pro because they're very nice quality, and they're Beats. I like Beats. My favorite part about Beats is you can wear them around your neck comfortably, not just to be stylish or to be like all these other kids, but I like to wear them around my neck when I'm not listening to them because I don't like putting them in my backpack. That's just me. It comes with that cord that I showed you, and it comes with kind of a crappy case. It comes with this kind of case, which it's nice to have some case come with it, but this isn't protecting it. I am going to go to slappa.com and buy a nice slappa case. It comes with microfiber, and it also comes with a fine USB cable. This is the nicest USB cable I've ever seen. It's so nice. It's got like the Beats red cord, and then the connectors are very nice. And where that plugs in is, this is the left ear. And it goes right in between this plastic part and there. You can't see it very well, I'm sorry. Yeah, it's right in here anyways. And this cord just plugs right in, and you charge it. And that's how it charges. Rechargeable, there's no batteries you put in there at all. That's just how it works, but yeah. If you really want the wireless, I'd go for it. It's really cool sometimes, and it's very useful. Like, I put my iPad on Bluetooth. I play my songs. I put my iPod, my iPad in my backpack, and then I just walk around and use the controls on the side of the mic, which it works perfect for me. It may not for you. So that's why I'm just being completely honest. The Bose QC15s have the nicest sound quality and the best noise cancellation. I would suggest those headphones or Beats Pro or Nicer. I don't know about the Studio Beats because they're bigger, they fit around your ear, it's more comfortable. $300 is a lot. As long as you're paying that much, go with the QC15. Solos, I do not like Solos at all. That's personal opinion. If you want a pair of Beats just to wear them around your neck and show people you have them, you can buy the Solos. But personally, I would go with the wireless. In order of best headphones, I'd probably go Bose QC15, the Beats Pro, which are like $400, like, or the Toxic are $300, I suppose. And then I'd go with the wireless, and then the Studio and the Pros. And that's my order. But thank you all for watching. I really appreciate it. If you have any other questions, please let me know. I'll comment back within a few days. I check my YouTube often, even though I only get like 20 views a video, but trying to get more. So thank you so much for watching, and just if you want to subscribe, please do, or if you have any suggestions for other videos, I'd be more than happy to do it. I have a PlayStation and an Xbox, so just let me know your questions, and I'll get back to you. And yeah, thanks for watching. See ya.